In this session, we are going to work with relieving any kind of stress that you may have in any kind of your life areas. And we are also going to work with increasing the energy and with uplifting our spirit and mood. I'm going to start with light some incense here, just to sort of set the space for this session and clearing away anything, you know. So I'm going to light one of these incense. And these are really nice because they have some type of Indian kind of scent. A very kind of warm scent, you know, and it has a very kind of exotic, you know, Asian kind of scent. So I will start off with lighting this incense. So we're going to clear away anything that is now causing you a form of stress. Bringing in the kind of, you know, fire element. Okay. I'm going to set this aside here. And then I'm going to allow the smoke here to work around in your energy field to just get this clearing off here, you know. So we don't have anything that is causing stress. And there is like different forms of stress, you know. And this is important to understand that there are two different types of stresses. You have positive stress, which is helping you to achieve different kinds of things in your life. And that can be positive. And then you have negative form of stress, which is causing this kind of, you know, imbalances and just really strain on your body and your resources that you have in your body. So I think we have clear now the space here. This smoke. I'm going to, you know, take out the smoke. So stress can actually be, you know, a good thing. It's a way for the body, you know, to achieve different things, you know, in very demanding kind of situations. But it is also, you know, shouldn't be going to a overdrift where you are like experiencing this kind of strain. And that's what we're going to sort of work with in this session. To sort of just release the stress, you know. We may not be able to impact the things in this regarding to what is causing the stress, but we can actually, you know, help you in how you are responding to different things that might be stressful, you know. So in your life, at any kind of moment, you can perceive your life to be like a wheel, you know? So So in any moment, your life is representing a wheel, and this wheel is consisting of different areas. So each of these lines here, you know, and parts are representing different areas of your life. And for the wheel to be in balance and be able to move effortlessly, you know, along your life path, then each of these, you know, parts of your life must sort of be in a balance. I mean, it's okay to have smaller types of imbalances, you know, but I mean, if there is a wobbly kind of wheel, then it also means you're gonna move much more difficult along your life path. So what you wanna do is to focus, you know, just as you are visualizing, in how your life at this moment, you know, can transfer into being a fully functioning wheel, where all parts of your life is equally balanced, you know. And even if you may not are ready for it, you know, even if you're not ready to transform or, you know, work with some areas in your life, that's okay. It's fully okay. So instead, what we will do is that we will release the stress that you may have in any of these areas of your life regarding, you know, how you are perceiving your life and situations, you know, and how they are affecting you. And just allow, you know, for your wheel to be however that might be, you know. So to give you the strength, you know, to sort of strengthen your own capability, you know, to handle different kinds of stressful situations, you know, we're going to work with this. Now this one is really sort of a solar plexus kind of chakra stone, you know. I mean, you can work with this one even beyond the chakra system, you know, because I know that not everyone is, you know, adhering to get the concept first of all of chakras. But even if you're doing like yoga or, you know, any kind of Eastern kind of religious practice, most of them have the concept of, you know, the energy centers in the body. For example, in yoga you have all these kinds of, you know, nodes going around in your body. So the tiger eye is operating across your entire energy field, you know, with this kind of strengthening energy, you know, and it's just helping you, you know, to find the strength to hold up against the stress, and also to understand that the external factors in your life, we may not always be able to, you know, affect them, but we can affect how we are feeling, you know. So when something is just overloading us, we can sort of find some place in ourselves, you know, where we don't need to hold the things that are in the external world, but we can just hold ourselves, you know, hold our inner strength, you know. And this tiger eye is sort of bringing you your inner strength into its full force, you know. So you have the strength to conquer things seem very heavy, you know, and also to really, you know, raise the energy frequency here, you know, in your energy field, to be able, you know, to just, you know, experiencing stress sometimes when it is in a positive form, and also to, you know, sort of find clarity to be aware of when you are experiencing negative forms of stress. I have brought out some like clear angel or aura quartz here. I think it's actually angel's quartz, Because these were kind of more on the expensive or more pricey side, you know, stones. And I have them in this bag, in this brown bag. Just to keep the energy frequency sort of clean, you know, when I'm not using stones. So I have three different angel quartz here. And these are used, you know, sending you the energy here. But we can raise the frequency here around in your energy field and give you the clarity to sort of be able to work and face these type of stress reactions, you know. And also to have the strength to sort of step aside and just realize that you are experiencing stress, you know. And to pay attention, you know, to your inner kind of state of emotions and so forth, you know. So we have this really pretty kind of clear, nice stones, you know. And they are reflecting different kinds of energies, as you can tell, because they have different kinds of colors on them. And each color is one kind of, you know, frequency. So they really are holding a lot of different energies here. So I think the energy here is much kind of, you know, more uplifted. And we have, like, you know, gathered some strength, you know. This is, I'm gonna try and show you. This is these are like bells. These things are just going to fall over the place. And the reason for why I brought these bells with their sort of sound into here is because when we are stressed, we can definitely use the sound frequency, you know, to sort of calm on and shift our mind, you know, and how we are, you know, how we are experiencing our emotions in certain times, you know. Because sound can be very relaxing, you know. There is quite a lot of different colors and, you know, diversity in this bag, you know. And it's the same thing with how your emotions and, you know, how you're experiencing stress is taking its form over the day. You know, in certain moments we will experience stress, and then in other moments we will experience calm. And it's about to find a balance in these, you know, emotions, so we don't experiencing, you know, long-term stress. And that's why it's so important to sort of allow yourself to relax in between the times when you have had a experience of stress, you know, that has been more straining. Well, it can be very beneficial to, you know, do some kind of physical activity, you know. Typically, physical activity is good for most things, you know. So, for example, if you enjoy doing some power walks, or going to the gym, or doing some running, or Pilates, whatever you sort of enjoy doing, tennis, and find something that is suitable for you. You do not need to do anything that is, you know, for someone else, you know. Just do whatever, you know, you feel is the right thing for you, you know. So if you really do not like yoga, or if you really do not like running, don't do it, you know. These are just my favorite kind of stuff, you know, and how I stay in a good kind of, you know, a good state of health. And for you to kind of continue to remember your kind of, you know, your life path, you know, regardless of how stressful this wheel, regardless of how stressful this wheel of your life might make you feel in any kind of moment, it's always important to, you know, think that stress and any kind of emotion is going to, you know, it's going to shift and transform as you're moving along your life path. And for you to sort of have a clear vision of your life path, these types of malachite is a really good thing to have, because it connects you directly to your heart. And as I have said in some other videos here, your heart is really where you can sort of keep this kind of visualization of your life path, you know. So you have like this full kind of, you know, flow of some kind of path, you know. Because if you are alive, you're going to go, if you are alive, you're going to go through some kind of transformations, you know. And I mean, you have also the option to sort of be part in how those things are taking its turn and how they are occurring. But, you know, we don't move from, you know, from one stage to another. We have like, you know, kind of a continuity, you know. So not every single moment of your life is going to be having the exactly same energy frequency, and it's not going to, you know, be exactly the same amount of stress. And of course, if there is any kind of more, you know, long-term stress, then that's like another kind of topic, you know. But for this kind of negative stress that come and go, you know, and that we can experience, it's important to understand when that happens, you know. So you are aware that you have the strength to experiencing the moment, but also to be present in that you have the option to actually sort of choose your reactions to the things that are happening. Even if that might be to switch off, you know, shortly, you know, just to not really get yourself up into all of that stress, you know. And to find the things that sort of is making you feel calm, maybe visualize something that makes you feel much more relaxed, you know. That can be helpful in the times when you have experiences, you know, that are kind of, you know, making you feel more or less stressed, you know. The balance to just, you know, experiences are coming and going, But your inner strength is always present, you know. Your inner strength is always present, you know. Your inner strength is always present.